analyze and contemplate on why I chose to be great. I find myself trying to escape from where I'm supposed to be safe. Yeah. Or maybe I should pray like I'm supposed to be saved. Sometimes I feel like getting even, but I chose to behave. I'm mentally locked in a prison and I need bail. But the internet'll kill me quicker than the streets will. And if that shit doesn't kill me, then the police will. Or maybe all the refills on the e-pills or the lean will. I wish I was more flourished. I wish I had more courage. I feel like there's more purpose. Maybe it's all worth it. I want to keep on learning, but I couldn't be more nervous when I keep looking for answers. And I gotta keep on searching, the tables keep on turning. Try to call up the Jesus, but the phone keep on ringing. I think I need more service, the calls seem more urgent. And all I see is more murders, the soldiers keep on serving. I wonder if it's all worth it. I want
on our knees we pray.
Ran a marathon, man. You did a good job.
Here we go. So G-Man needs a man to set him straight. Oh, lowercase O. I am begging God. For that. I definitely need a man to set me straight.
You picked that out of the whole crowd.
Most of the time when I'm on hold on a minute, G-Man. Most of the time when I'm on social media. You know, a lot of these people down here that call themselves men are running south for the winter. So, I'm just saying, ain't no man gonna set me straight because I don't talk about stuff I don't know nothing about.
Oh my lord,
you're a clown.
Oh, tatted.
No, and since you're a clown, I'm about to stop being serious with you a minute in a minute, Frank. If you're going to be a clown, dude,
you've been serious this whole time.
I got it. No. Some of it was serious and some of it was me clowning. You can go back and watch the video and you'll see.
The ribs are pre-cooked. They're not fully done because we're going to pull them out of the oven.
I would literally chop your head off and nobody would be none the wiser. Oh, this is what you really look like? Oh, I'm off with my head.
What is him not fucking like me? Have to do anything with him, you fucking whore. You broke the fucking code, yeah.
What did I fucking do?
If he don't want to finish his ribs, that's his problem.
What the fuck?
You ever ejaculate while your sleep paralysis demon is present? That's fucked up shit.
You stupid motherfucker. You know what the fuck is?
No, he doesn't.
Can you control yourself for 2 fucking seconds?
Fuck. I'm just shitting myself.
What the fuck?
Sing out with spiders, and then he starts spitting on the people judging the bar. You know the difference between a refrigerator and a 5-year-old fridge doesn't scream when you put your meat in. Already. Is this a show?
Yeah, I guess we're doing a show.
For the people.
For the people, do your show.
I don't know who that is. Who's the resident pedo? Oh, is that me? Okay, good. I'm glad. Frank once said, you know the difference between a refrigerator and a 5-year-old? The fridge doesn't scream when you put it in meat.
Oh, no.
Oh, I don't feel good reading that. Thank you, Dad and Gimli. FrankFucksKids.com.
BillyFucksTeens.org, from what I hear.
I thought it would be a .gov.
So then you're a hebephile.
Yeah. I don't know. So the reason I'm getting called a hebephile is because the person really wanted to offend Donald Trump, an actual, like, confirmed hebephile, and now I am.
Yes.
That's how it goes, you know?
Also, if you're that fucking weirdo, we'll send you the link.
Oh yeah, that's fucking Bruce. There was never any doubt.
I think it'd be funniest if we let Anna read it. She's the best reader. Yeah, she's the best reader. We're all fucking functionally more retarded.
Yeah, he's right.
The Geek Room are leftist dipshits. They worship leftist fake news. And they too think I'm Bruce, lol. Wow. Everyone that is against Nick Bravo certainly believes some of his claims. Maybe he should offer evidence of what he claims. Same
we're
with the Geek Room
we'll
at
do
the
that
Geek
first
Room.
Fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand, T.
Will someone pay Peanut's internet bill? Loudly
no.
crying, rolling on the floor laughing.
You know what she's going to use that money for.
Drugs.
Oh, absolutely.
A nap.
at the Geek Room, I know Billy has a criminal record and has been hiding it for a while now. The Geek Room are a bunch of stupid, self-righteous hypocrites, and their content is white trash, progressive, liberal appropriation.
What?
Are we leftist, progressive, or liberal? Because those are
white
three
trash
separate.
Or
he got the white trash part right.
Like white trash, yes, I will absolutely like. I born and bred white trash.
Damn that! What's like, up?
My brother was born in fucking Owensboro, Kentucky. Like, sure.
Oh, that's sick. I see. And you lived in a car. By the
I
river.
I lived in a car.
By the
I
river.
I did sleep by a river once.
Yikes.
Yeah. It wasn't a very good river either. Okay, where were we? Oh, yes. They're racists, homophobes.
True.
Billy likes teenage girls like Nick
Not
Bravo.
True.
There's your teenage girls right there.
True.
And they all voted for that dickhead they call president that fucked up the U.S. economy. Sure.
Just realized
all the while they go around, dur, dur, Biden is doing a great job, dur, fuck you twats. No,
yeah, I totally don't do that.
None of us really do. We all call him out when he does fuck shit. And I like to.
So much shit for being old.
And he didn't fuck up the economy. There's this weird thing that you probably don't think existed. It was called COVID that really fucked up the economy. And our economy out of the world's economy is actually doing really well.
It fucked up far more than just our economy is the thing. So you would have to concede that every leader on damn near planet Earth at that period
is Biden.
Failed.
Yeah, or no, it is Biden.
The problem is capitalism.
Well, and our economy is doing better than most other countries, yeah, so.
It probably would have taken me a long time to notice that no one can hear me, because these guys can hear me. I just didn't know the audience couldn't hear me, so. Anyway, this is, I think, him talking to himself, really. So I heard about Billy liking teeny girls.
It 100% is.
When you going to give me some of that hot tang?
Fucking yikes, Bruce.
And then it says, you ain't getting my thing, LOL. Only I get my thing, baby. Yeah.
Also, I would love to see my criminal record. Psycho. I would love to see my criminal record.
I don't even have a criminal record.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, dude, my criminal record is just, hey, he gets speeding tickets.
So this is a video from this channel, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
I took a screenshot.
Who does this sound like? Who does this sound like to everyone?
For some reason, I couldn't download it since it's unlisted.
Yeah, that's right.
Anna looking like a young DC media girl.
It's way hotter, though. Oh, Oxinium, it's the glasses.
It's the glasses.
But
Oxinium,
I did.
Oxinium, you're a dick. That's hilarious.
I did take a screenshot of it just to show who it is. The Beast in Me, Guilt, Shame, and Disparagement. This is from the same channel. And
yeah, Moose.
So we're gonna
voice, buddy.
Yeah, this is how we're gonna, like, since, because this is what Nick and Sabella been saying, because he has been just.
Sometimes Nick and Sabella are right. You don't have to always discredit everything they say because they're Nick and Sabella. It's called poisoning the well, you goddamn
Everyone
idiot.
Everyone knows that they're fuckwits, but they have, especially Nick, like, Nick's on this weird tear of owning people right now on
YouTube,
though.
That person's, like, immediately messaging the second you put some shit up. Either that is the thirstiest of bitches, or that's just you.
Yeah. Alright, so this is.
The Geek Room said, upset I said something about Billy's teeny girl. No one gives a fuck. I
laughed about it.
Why don't you go cry about it?
But here is his, like, crazy ass posting. Billy Light Teeny Girl, the Geek Room is hosted by Heavophile. That one's new.
Got him.
There we go.
Oh, yeah. See?
Then,
it's accurate toward Billy there.
Yeah.
The only people who know the right term are the people who have looked up to the right term.
Mm-hmm.
What am I?
So,
am I Animancer now?
Yeah.
I think so. That's how this works.
God damn it.
Make sure I'm mad. Let's see.
Okay, I want to discuss something.
Bruce-y. Okay, that's fucking Bruce. Fuck you. I'm not into kids, you fucking loser. God damn.
That one line that we just heard Anna read from the shameful display there, where it's like, they think I'm Bruce. Lol. No,
yep.
We know you're fucking
you're
Bruce.
A
real gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand, T.
Anna be pretty with the danglers hashtag blame Frank hashtag F Billy.
Why am I getting blamed?
And Mo, I'm pretty sure you're not a teenage girl, so I'm not interested, apparently.
17-year-old specifically.
Mo likes the danglers.
Duh, he's Puerto Rican, of course. He's a criminal, just like he didn't serve cause he ain't American.
That's right, liquid Billy.
Thank you.
Got him.
You know what? Billy. Yeah, let's put
got
start
him.
On that one.
Yeah, you're only doing this because I'm Mexican.
Yeah. You're only doing it because he's Cuban.
Yeah. Well, hey.
And that makes it way more racist. Frank saying olé.
Olé.
It's so much worse than me saying I'm Mexican.
In fact, I...
Hey, Bruce, you're invited. And Bruce, I know you're watching. You're a giant fucking loser and you have nothing else going on in your life.
He's
and it makes you
watching.
And it makes you upset that even Sabella's doing better in her life without you, which, you know what? If that was me, chandelier time. So, you can come on anytime. Say something in the chat. We'll give you the link. You are not blocked on any of your fucking weird accounts. We'll give you the link and I'll shit on you openly. It's just some shit I can do. And I'd love to see my criminal history that you apparently have seen. Let's go, bitch. Not
Folks,
up or shut
Billy
up.
Billy is gonna make a Blippi 2.0.
Right, I'll sit here and you
laugh. Seriously, Anna looks cute with the dangler glasses.
Thank you, Mo. But
the danglers, Mo.
Dangler.
And this time, Bruce, we will remember to record the cry session afterwards.
Yes.
Like we did with the call for uprising. That was, yes. That was our bad.
Yeah, that was sad.
God, I still hate myself for not catching it.
I hate you for a lot of other reasons.
If we get the opportunity for another therapy stream, I'm going to fucking call you all kinds of fuck shit, dude.
Billy's going to yell stuff at you. Bran might say some stuff because, you know, you got to get his jabs in. I'll sit here and laugh as the person that everybody just forgets when they decide to call us homophobic.
And I'll sit here and giggle.
I want to bring up the fact that he was stressed over losing the fucking mashed potatoes vampire for an old lady. he cried.
The mashed potatoes vampire is doing way better.
She's doing 100% better.
You know what?
Even being mashed potatoes vampire, which is a huge disadvantage.
Dude,
I'm
she's
sure.
doing better with Nick Bravo. Nick, I got drunk across the street. Bravo is providing a better life. Yeah.
God damn it. I mean, dude, lowest of bars, granted, but
yeah, but he's fucking overcoming that bar.
That's it wasn't weird. The bar was set on the ground, weird, so
yeah. It was. But usually with Nick, you'd expect him just to trip over the bar and then die somehow.
Trip over the bar and just get drugged like this.
He's fighting the road.
That's in our fucking weird community thing. He has the most viewed video. It's that video, yeah. But he has the most viewed video. It's him getting a drug across the street, but he still has the most viewed video. Good job, Nick. Probably.
And see, G-Man, that's how we do it. We drag everybody. Yep. Let's listen to more Bruce.
A real gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand.
Billy just said he would openly defecate on Dave?
I don't know. Whatever idiot wants to fucking come on and be fucking dumb, I will fucking argue with them. It's literally like what
he's,
I do.
He's gonna blippy
hey,
2.0.
Feel like getting yelled at by Billy from the Geek Room?
Come on
oh,
down.
It's such a good time. And people used to sign
right
up for
up,
it.
Sir.
Yeah.
And then...
We had a thing going on, and then people are like, you know what?
I broke them too quickly.
Yeah, that was the problem. Like, within 45 seconds, Nephilim's gone. The rest of them are like, yeah, never mind.
I was
kick
a
rock,
on,
sport.
Man. He yes, said, he literally said that the moon got jizzed on by the Earth.
What?
Were
yeah, it's
there?
The lunar bukkake theory. It's idea. Yeah, it's not even kidding. It's okay. So, you know how there's craters on the moon?
Yeah.
Well, those came here. Those are on the moon. Those are crumb craters. So, what happened was Noah's flood happened, as it did, apparently.
Whalers.
And then the water had to go somewhere. So, in God's grand wisdom, he jizzed it on the moon, causing ice crystals to shoot off of the planet, because apparently when water moves real quick, it doesn't actually heat up and turn to gas. It turns into ice for some weird reason in this reality, and it hits the moon, causing craters.
Whalers on the moon.
Okay.
Carry
you
a
know,
harpoon.
When you said lunar bukkake, I thought of like a Sailor Moon hentai.
Skeet skeet.
Oh, that's probably yeah.
I have no
idea. It's because Sailor Moon weird dudes are just there. Could you imagine, like, if you ever met a dude and you're like, hey, what's your favorite anime? And they said Sailor Moon. I'm pretty sure you need to run away from them.
Like, either they're gay or
oh,
there's something very wrong with them.
Oh, yeah. If they're gay, you're probably fine. But if it's a straight dude, run. Just run.
That's a general rule of thumb, I think. If it's a straight dude, just run.
It's
that's true
it's
as
like
well.
Tokyo.
I want to talk to you about the
word.
If it's what?
Tokyo Mew Mew.
Never seen it.
Mew Mew.
It's magical cat girls.
I said hey to Bruce.
That's why I haven't seen it. I'm blocked.
I don't know if I'm locked on here or not, but I just said
I'm
hey.
I'm already
anyway.
Blocked. He's over there talking about me diddling teenagers and already has me preemptively blocked. Like
and now
bitch.
That now that we've told him the jig is up, he's going to be like talking to us through his fake girlfriend's account. Great.
She's from Canada. She's totally real.
Yeah, we wouldn't know her.
Nah.
Dude, you had to make up a fake girlfriend because you lost Sabella.
Because you lost mashed potatoes, vampire bitch. That's what you cry in your front yard about. You remember that when you cried and we laughed at you? You remember that? Get in here, bitch.
I would be the shittiest. I would be the shittiest of chandeliers right now. God damn, dude.
And Teddy Gimli said, for being a member for 20 months, Star Wars is a bankrupt franchise, and White is awful in MTG.
White is awful by itself in Magic the Gathering. That is true. That's why you pair White with other colors, because it's a really good setup card deck. So, suck my nuts, A. And B, the Star Wars is amazing. Kill yourself in Minecraft.
The gameplays, folks.
White Black's really good. White blue's also really good, and white red is really good as well. White green is dog shit.
I like the white black because you got the dueling, like give yourself health, vampirize, health off other people.
Oh yeah, dude! If you can get a like a really decent vampire desk or vampire deck that can also like just like cripple them the way like they're trying to set up shit. Oh god. That's what white blue's really good as well.
It's the gameplay, folks.
White blue's a little more efficient at it.
We got Magic the Gathering hoodie.
And then white red is good because then you can get a shit ton of goblins out like a dick.
Oh god, the goblin decks.
Yeah, but what's a goblin?
I
just want
goblin. Billy. Or you can do it green and do like.
I hate green and white. There's a new meta right now where they put up like little creatures that can give you lands. And then it like you can get a shit ton of big greens out real quick. I hate green.
Totally not. Yato says, I'd get terrified every time Billy says black.
I would too if I gave a shit about the channel.
How close the word deck is for people who live in like the northeast corner of the
United States. That's true. We do say deck pretty close to dick.
It's pretty close.
Bruce, why the fuck did you make up a criminal history on me? You fucking weirdo.
Welcome to the club, Billy.
I know, but at least you went to court.
Thank you.
A real gentleman would do that.
And with Bullhorn Betty that one time.
Bullhorn Betty.
Bella has a CSA reenactor swimsuit calendar.
Sabella has a CSA reenactor swimsuit calendar?
I don't know what that is, and
CSA?
I don't want to know.
Confederate States of America swimsuit
calendar.
Okay. Okay.
It was a gift with the blanket from that one dude, Leonard Skinner. Or whatever her lame story was for having a Confederate flag in her home.
That was actually a pretty funny part with that fucking Frank Feng Shui G-Man on and like, ah, you're friends with Sabella, she traces this, and he's like, really, Doc?
Frank, I heard he went on a tirade asking you who the fuck I was.
He did. He said, who the fuck is Brian?
I
thinks MTG is a pretty politician hashtag XFit.
I lost my shit when he said that.
Fuck you. I know who Marjorie Taylor Greene is, and I love Magic the Gathering. I hate one, love the other one.
Because he was like, he thought that when he first talked to us, it was me, Billy, and Bionic Dance.
I thought you were talking about the mean lady with the blue hair.
No. Like, so
basically, whenever Billy came on the show, I disappeared at that point.
Apparently.
Because everything before then was attributed to Billy that I did.
Oh, apparently.
Okay.
Because he was going to say something about like teaching me the history or something like that.
I don't want that because I know what the first video on this channel was, Bran. No, thank you.
What was the first video on this channel?
You throwing something and hitting your friends in the nuts and him being white said the N-word.
That wasn't on this channel?
That wasn't on this channel.
I thought it was. I thought we had to delete it.
No.
Where was that at?
That was just... I think that was his Periscope.
Whose Periscope?
The Your fucking friend? Weird racist guy.
Oh, okay. I don't know. I have our timelines mixed up, too. All I know is I'm not Bran.
I don't know. He just... he wanted to know the...
According to Gary.
He said he was going to teach me to... He said something like teaching me the history on the TGR, then said, who is Bran? I lost my shit. Like, and he was shocked that you were here from the very beginning. He's like, really? I was like, you got to be...
Philosophical question to the core.
I was like, you got to be...
Who the fuck is Brian?
Like, goofing on me right now because you can't be serious. He's like, no, I'm serious. I was like,
Yeah, he's very dumb.
That was.
He's been on here with us.
I'm well, Carrie, allow me to introduce myself. I have a clean penis. I've been struck.
He brought that up again today. He brought that up again about the dirty pee pee.
Well, don't get so many UTIs, it won't be funny.
He thinks it's still because of fucking dehydration.
Too much salt.
Of course, Billy, like black and white, cause it's the same color as his underwear.
Damn, Will. What are you eating?
I don't fucking know what that fucking means. But I'm primarily a white and red, which would have been a way funnier joke.
Anna called Gary a stupid thumb. He didn't get it.
Yes.
Yeah. Gary Bear's a special case.
I had to remind him that our first interaction with him was with me, Bran, and Trevor Vision. That was our first interaction with G-Man.
Oh, the guy that God couldn't read his screen name very well.
Yes.
Smited. Are you telling me it's Trevor 2000?
Oh, shit.
Fuck. Well, I only did the resurrecting thing one time. I don't feel like doing it again.
Guess I'm not so infallible now. Jesus.
Not you. Well, this angel I have on Earth, the Archangel, standoff and really, really fucked him up here. And I thought he had Coke bottle glasses, and I had to kill him.
Megatron's hunting a squirrel, for fuck's sake. I don't even know why I sent these fucks.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
You know what? I really need some comic relief up here, and I feel like he's unappreciated on the ground. I'm going to go murder this lobster. I'll be right back.
Yeah. Abortions are us. We're better than coat hangers, folks.
Turns out I didn't have to do much. Time was doing that like a motherfucker. He's up here, though.
He's like, oh, he's almost. Okay, never mind. Don't need that.
On my side.
Wait for people to come in. This ain't a live stream where I'm talking to people. I'm just going to say something fast. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Have a good one.
And that's it.
There was a comment on a video Shanny did that from a person.
Yeah, what if he just like, neck thinged into a stroke and just passed on right there? Like
that would have been that'd be my favorite stream ever. That'd be the taxpayers of Pennsylvania's favorite stream ever too. They just saved 50% on that household. Actually, you know Shanny would hide it for a while to keep the money. Like his body would be just bug
she
crawling.
Would consume him. Let's
you
be real.
You say you needed it funny in here?
Yeah.
There's always room for Jello.
Well, I'm not getting off camera. I'm not getting on camera, but I'll do my best.
Actually, they were always nice. I don't understand why they became not nice like this, but I'm just going to say
Nana.
This really fast for the sake of Danny.
And this is in. Jello's still a dick.
What?
Jello's also still stupid.
I was just doing a greeting. That's a pleasant thing. It's a pleasantry.
You're such a cunt.
Jello gives Nana the good chair. You guys remember
exactly.
That, right?
Exactly.
Dude, that lost us at least $200 a month.
There is a good chair for more next to me for Nana. Like
that joke alone costs us $200 a month.
Yeah. I'm kind of sorry about that. I mean,
you divide it up by all 87 members of the Geek Room. That was like a dollar. Who cares?
It's extra buck a month.
That shit was so goddamn fun.
They said this. Basically, look, I was trying to tell you the whole time that your diet was bad or something. Your nutrition ideas were wrong. And now look at the position you're in. Wrong. Completely false.
Ow.
Stupid.
What? Dude, you're eating PBJR.
Well, they're talking about Shanny's eating habits, and look where it got
her.
So how the fuck are
diet.
They wrong? Yeah, she sees food, she eats it.
She eats it. Yeah.
There's I saw a video of those like people like mouthing off to the cops and then getting arrested videos.
Oh, those
I saw
funny.
This one that was a 400-pound lady gets arrested on a bus.
No,
and you. And she's the one that says during it that she's 400 pounds. Like she gets down to her knees and they're like, get up. She's like, I can't, I'm 400 pounds. And and finally they get her up and drag her off the bus. And you see the two cop or cop on each side of her and they're walking. And I'm like, the size difference between this lady and the cops is, you know, very obvious, but nowhere close to the that picture of Shani in the ambulance next to that human being.
Yeah.
that you could barely tell is there. Like, she's like the size of what embarrassed.
She's sitting there embarrassed looking at you. No!
In the name of Zeus's beehole, contact Jason's uncle and tell him that he is a victim of elder abuse, as his house is being buried in fecal matter.
Nah, fuck him. I think he likes it now.
It's funny, but please don't anybody get into anybody's real life, you know? Unless it's like a positive thing. Like, if you see a deck of cards that you'd like to send Billy, just
don't.
Hit me up. I'll give you his address. No problem.
Really funny.
No, but let's
send 150 bucks with your.
Man. we don't want to get into other people. That's not real life. Leave it here.
Keep your hands inside the car.
Folks, the grab of the day is the pea crab. Love you, Papa.
Oh, so happy.
Thank you, Billy's that. Casting couch crabs.
I don't know why the Papa part got me.
Why is that account still a thing?
This account is a thing, so every week we can know the crab of the week.
Right?
Well, it says crab of the day. So.
Exactly, so we need to stream more, apparently.
I do not. Absolutely fucking not.
It's our job.
I don't have any insomnia, but I don't need to. Like,
we're professionals.
We are not professionals.
We are professionals. Yeah,
right, it's over here in the thing.
If Cokes had crabs,
yeah, it's right here.
I was gonna play the same thing.
If Cokes had crabs and then got with Jessica, would they then be blue crabs? I'm just curious.
I fucking.
I'm just trying to understand how this terrible joke. Works. That's
you're
all.
A cunt.
I need to be louder.
We're professionals.
So pay us.
Nah, wrong.
Okay, fine. Damn,
Mario. Really?
Jesus.
I gotta agree with him there.
Just because you're broke doesn't mean we should be broke, too. A-hole.
We have these weird things called jobs.
Oh, imagine that.
Hey.
Completely wrong. The reason...
No,
fuck you, right? I actually have a job, bitch.
Oh, yeah, what are you talking about?
Imagine
I gotta go there tomorrow.
Me too.
I'm disabled
right now. No! No! Never take health advice from someone who's been wearing the same Millennium Falcon sweater for over 2 years thinks he enjoys being peed on.
That is a Millennium Falcon sweater.
I really liked that sweater when he first got it, too.
I'm gonna get you one, Billy.
I was like, that one looks dope, man.
No, wants that exact one.
I don't want that exact one.
I feel like that top part used to be white.
It was.
It was, yeah.
Shannon,
look, I thought it was cool, but I don't like sweaters with that shit in the inside. It always freaks me out.
How long would it take to fumigate that fucker? Yeah, assuming you did get that one.
How long? What?
If assuming you were able to get a hold of the sweater that's on him, how long do you think it would take to fumigate it?
Oh, dude, I would do this weird thing called throw it away.
Just fucking blowtorch it in the backyard.
You have to wear it. You have to wear it, or you have to consume vegetables. Which are we doing?
Dude, there's some Spanish dishes that I can eat vegetables.
Just the vegetables, nothing else.
Oh, just the vegetables? That's fucking racist. I can't have chicken fricassee.
Absolutely not.
That's racist. What the?
That's racist as fuck, dude.
You're trying to be fucking vegetableist, bitch. So I don't want to.
I am. I'm very vegetableist.
What's the hardest part about eating vegetables, Billy?
The wheelchair. Do it. Welcome, Kamal. Come grift our channel again.
Come on down. Oh, no, it's not wheelchair accessible. He can't stop.
Can't stop, won't stop.
No more breaks.
He's in the position.
I think the sound effect was too much.
Oh, look, he fell right into a grift. He's really resourceful.
went throughout her body. After she has suffered a severe injury to her knee at the age of what, honey? What? How old were you?
Line!
17.
Blind.
What's the thing I say so I don't get hit?
It was 17. It was in Boulder, Colorado. She was whitewater rafting type of deal. And she smashed you.
A real gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand, T.
Veggie's positive in anyone's real life. Hi, Billy.
Thank you, Chubb the Cucumber.
Me on a rock, and she messed it up. Her parents were what you would call totally neglectful and said, your pain is fake. Walk it off.
You know about that as a parent, right?
Hmm.
The only time you paid those kids any attention is where you were kicking them.
My chest hurts. Walk it off.
Filming in progress.
You said what about the devil's advocate?
Those kids banging on that door. We need to go to the bathroom.
Papa, why do you dislike us so much? We just need to inform the people.
Right? It's the cutest little crab. As he is.
Thank you.
A real gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand, T.
FYI, Billy is convinced oregano is a vegetable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's true, it's very leafy.
Look, there he is.
Hmm.
Right on fucking cue.
Result of their disgusting parenting, non-parenting, going to the hospital to get their daughter medical attention for her knee that was injured. They instead told her the whole time that she's saying, my knee hurts, my knee hurts, my knee hurts. It's fake. That you're faking it. There's no pain here.
So massive amounts of DoorDash that you paid for had nothing to do with the reason that she can't get off the fucking couch because she's fat as fuck now?
No.
I think there's some nuance here. I might be wrong.
You are.
But I think he's accepting that she's big without saying it. I think what he's saying is she became immobile after the knee injury, and then as a result,
got big.
But he's ignoring the fact that she like actually did work at one point, and that would have been after that.
Yeah, well, she worked when they first got to Colorado. There's that fucking video of them going to the zoo.
Shani said she was right rotter rafting.
She helps it stay afloat. She's very buoyant.
Surprisingly so, yeah.
Shani was the raft that day.
If you were trying to tell me she was riding in a submarine, I'm going to have some problems with that. I don't think she can fit, and the thing could never submerge with her in it. But whitewater rafting, I'll bet you she could have been the raft. There might have been six people sitting on her back.
Dude, she would be like a terrible time for a Virginia-class sub trying to get down there, man.
You know?
Her parents were so abusive, they didn't have the money for a raft, so they made Shani's fat ass get in the water.
They were horribly abusive.
Isn't that right,
Shani? Horribly abusive, taking her on a vacation, going whitewater rafting in Colorado.
And they like just four, sat on her
like
thighs.
17 states over.
They just sat on her thighs and put paddles in the water. It was disgusting.
Her mom dislocated her shoulders.
And put her in the water.
To use them as oars.
They were for fun. She said, Shani, this arm's sticking out the wrong way. We need a rudder. Yank.
That she's now going to be, she's 40 now. And the osteoarthritis that stemmed from the wound that she had, the injury, has gone through her whole body. That's how this works. That's how osteoarthritis works. That is the reason she's in this position. Her mobility tanked. Even since I've been with Shani, which is 6 years.
Yeah, because you fed her.
She's gotten fatter since you've been with her. That's why her mobility is tanked since you've been with her.
She is a tank. Too.
I've seen a massive decline, especially within the last few years.
I've seen her get massive.
If you talk to an actual doctor, thank you for the hearts. If you talk to an actual doctor...
Are they crinkle?
Sure. They will tell you that this is a progressive disease that has very like no treatments. There's no good active plan that you can be
not that
on
kind
to
of doctor
rehabilitated from this disease. It's something that
my favorite joke of all time now is when Jello described the type of doctor he is to Sam and told him he's not that type of doctor. He goes, "No, I am that type of doctor." No, I know you're not.
No.
Oh, that was fucking
just
great.
Just accepting it wouldn't have been funny.
I know, it's just hilarious.
What a surprise. Jello's wrong again. You know, so what? Arguing with him about what he does. Now that's funny.
For the rest of your life, through pain management, physical therapy, and exercise. That's the truth.
I don't care what anybody says. Billy will always be a train conductor to me.
Choo-choo, buckaroo.
So, for you to come in with such an ignorant comment, it was deleted. It was a... I was trying to tell you this the whole time, Shani. Your nutrition. Shani is not Foodie Beauty. Shani is not Amberlynn Reed.
Yeah, Foodie Beauty can walk.
Nah. Well, if you can call that walking.
I mean, when's the time you saw Shani get off the couch?
Fair.
Not a binge eater.
Not anymore.
Wait.
You can't binge eat if you have $7.
Yeah. Might be able to binge eat like what?
Air.
Slim Jims, maybe?
I mean, unless she's sitting there eating an entire fucking box of ramen.
I feel like I bring up this point way too often, but does anybody have any clue how many calories she'd have to eat every day just to maintain her weight? Not get bigger, but just to maintain her weight.
No, I remember that doctor that one time did it, how long she could survive without eating.
Could survive more than a year.
Like she had to drink water and then like take like a very small amount of protein every day.
The problem is that Rev wouldn't last that year because she would kill him.
She'd murder him.
See what she does. She does not binge eat. Okay.
Oh shit, dude, this is a perfect example. Oh, Bruce. Fucking what's his fuck? What's his name? Fucking Shani's ex? Chris. When Chris broke up with Shani or she left, he didn't make fake soccer accounts talking to himself and like being weird like that.
He did not. Mm-mm. He just moved on with his life. Yeah, I assume things got better for him.
They did.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, is Bruce aware what people in this chat tend to think about her? Like,
he also doesn't like us.
Well, no, I get that, but
he called me a kitty diddler.
that's
a teeny bopper, actually. I think that's what he called you.
Wow, that's Jesus, that's the worst way to use that fucking term I've ever heard. Yikes! Is that? Did you think of that today, or is that just on your head? Jesus, yeah, that's impressive.
Is that like that Cindy Lauper song? I bop.
Well, Billy,
I hate you so much.
So, thank you for the cuddle, nice emojis, Jen. Thank you. Yeah, when a comment like that comes through, you need to know that it's not going to be there anymore because
we get
really
rid of honesty. We will have no honesty.
Shani's position has nothing to do with weight.
What?
Could you back that up?
So then what? So then
Shani can't.
So then wait a minute. So how does the knee play into it then? I like even going with what Jello said, like the knee making it to where she can't exercise. She's still fat, and that's still a problem, right?
You still have to eat a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It just says it, like you can't fucking not move, and you just immediately gain weight. That's not how it works.
Like having all that excess weight on your joints is fucking terrible. Like real bad.
Yeah.
And like, oh, it's because of an injury that happened. Like, okay, even if that injury did happen, at this point now the weight is exacerbating that.
I went from 250 to 300 pounds at 6 foot tall, and it's not bulking on muscle.
What are you saying about what 450 now?
No, I'm at about just over 300, dude.
Are you sure it's not 400? I saw you recently.
No, you didn't.
I did, man.
I don't even have a working camera anymore.
I did, dude. I can tell. The waves are moving a little bit different on that side of the coast.
the tides are coming in faster. You must be gaining weight. but my point is that just that 50 pounds, I can, like, if I'm like, on my 150 knees pounds. Or, like, sitting, like, cross-legged and I go to get up, there's a big difference. I can feel it. Believe me, it's the difficulty she must have just getting off of the couch. I can't imagine. And yes, it hurts the joints. It very much hurts the joints.
I can give you some pretty decent workouts if you need them. I've done it before. Right, Frankie?
Yeah. Billy's been helping me. And also,
but I don't know shit about fitness, apparently.
Ted, that Billy needs that $15, so.
Wow. The hebo and the pedo are working together. You guys hear that? I've never been so happy to have been forgotten.
Right.
Oh, my
next
God.
Week on the Hebo and the Pedo, they're going to get into hijinks trying to tell their neighbors that they're on the list.
You two should totally do a show.
I am by law obligated to tell you that I'm on the
list. I think that would be a great idea. Frank and Billy, the Hebo and the Pedo.
A real gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand, T.
Frank, why do you want Shanny to back it up? Need 15.
Back it up. 15, amen.
Shanny's position has nothing to do with weight.
How can he say that with a straight face?
He knows he'll get beat if he doesn't. I mean,
turning.
He should at least wink a little or something after saying that.
Yeah, like
do the neck thing. Or
yeah, work a neck thing in there. Come on, Rev. Let us know you know you're full of shit. Let's
yeah,
see.
At least let us know you're in on the joke.
You know what? I really wish the South Korean show, The Squid Game, switched names to the TV show, The Hunger Game. Because Rev looks like he's playing it. He looks like he's hungry.
So wait, is he winning the game then?
I guess.
Dude, he's just trying not to die.
He never would have poked a hole in the sugar. He would have been going around trying to eat everybody's scraps.
Okay, it's like Squid Game. It's like Squid Game, but the longer he stayed with Shanny, that pig in the middle that filled up with the money that was winnings, it was just his inheritance going away.
That's so sad.
Yeah, it's pretty sad. He put it face that way, yeah. And but he stayed in the game. He didn't hit the button. That's
not that sad. That she couldn't move and do things. And it's progressive. It gets worse year after year. And they're right, because I've seen it. When she first came to me, she...
And the bright side, he got rid of player 3 and 4.
She could carry stuff.
I like how he just admitted she's getting fatter every year they've been together.
Three and four with the tripod.
Together and she could walk around. Yeah, Shanny is getting exercise.
The financial burdens.
She's getting exercise.
Being grabbed by exercise. For
now. Shanny burns a lot of calories, leaping to the conclusion.
Billy, you shouldn't talk when you're built like a busted can of biscuits. Hashtag fat Billy.
Wow, you guys are really good. Thank you.
That wasn't Oos.
That wasn't Oos?
That was Dad and Gimli.
Oh, Jesus. Get Dad and Gimli. Come on. You're dumbing him down a bit now.
Stronger again. It's like my mom went through that. It's a... My mom was in a hospital bed.
Let me tell you what Vaughn's mom went through. Or what went
she
through her.
She got fucked. Vaughn's penis.
Months?
The little red one.
Because she got sepsis, and that really, that knocks the shit out of you. And really she was up. In a bed, not moving much for 3 months. So she was in PT for almost a year.
How long did she lay in bed and try to get rid of it before she went to the hospital? I'm just saying she might not have been in the hospital for 3 months had she actually done something to take care of it rather than try to fulfill her fucking fantasies.
Yeah. And also, she had sepsis. Like, did they Did they test her for diabetes by any chance?
She tested positive, so she doesn't have it. Yeah. Positive means good, Anna.
And the positive good means good. I'm positive she ain't got it.
If it only matters what you know it to be the truth. Well, no, I don't. That's not true. But if that, I know you're supporting us, Jen, and that's nice. But that, no, I'm not saying, oh, just whatever we say is right. No, okay? What I'm saying is this person has this perception that Shani's illness and the position she's in, quote unquote,
self-inflicted,
is due to her weight. It's due to the fact that she's eaten too much.
Yes.
And that's her problem. It's not. I've seen what she eats.
Or she almost murdered you over grasshoppers a few months ago. You remember that?
That shit was hilarious. She almost got you arrested over a Baja Blast. There it is.
Beat you with a fucking sex whip.
Over a Baja Blast. You probably said you weren't going to get her shit, so she kicked your ass.
Her problem.
You are a bitch.
Her problem is an immobility due to osteoarthritis. And that's why she's medically cleared to get the bariatric surgery, because her doctor knows all this. It's a legitimate reason to do the surgery, because this is a result of her osteoarthritis.
But they also make sure you're going to stay on a diet and lose the weight.
She's not going to do that, though.
Shani he believes Shani's bullshit line about she got okayed for the... like the gastric bypass surgery, right?
No, she signed up for the Navy after this.
Well, but my point is that if he believes that, then how is he gonna like say it has nothing to do with it? No one is gonna okay you for the. Hey, Billy.
Oh, your knee's injured. Yeah.
Billy, why don't you go to a doctor next time you go to the doctor? Just say, hey, could I get liposuction? Is that something I can do? Just see what they say. They're gonna tell you no. It has to be a real problem. Just a little bit of a, you know, busted biscuit tin look. That's not enough. That's
Jesus, not enough. Fuck you, you fat fuck.
If you wore a tight shirt, you'd look like a sausage.
Oh, fuck me in the ass. But, no, but Shani signed up for the Navy post the Colorado trip. She was in the Navy for like 2 weeks. She didn't get discharged because her knee's fucked up. She got discharged because she's fucking crazy.
Wait.
I heard there's some constant discharge going. Never mind.
Jesus Christ, get out.
Put yourself in the corner, Bran.
Nobody puts Brian in the corner.
Non-original member of the Geek Room and such.
Yeah, I'm a newbie.
When did he get there?
Like a month ago.
That's it.
Fucking Brian.
So, you know, finally Fasting for Life, that was the user. They've usually been extremely nice, but you messed up on this one. Okay? Don't be throwing at Shani. Look at the position you're in now. I told you, you could have changed your nutrition. No, it's beyond that. It's beyond that. Her health conditions are far graver than just Amberlynn or Chantal, who has an eating disorder. I mean, Chantal had cancer. Okay, God bless her. And I think Amber did too. They both had cancer, which is horrible.
I thought Shani had cancer too.
You want to come in, Brucey boy?
Is he here?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, there's Bruce right in the chat. Come on in, Bruce.
Hey, I got you, buddy.
Come on in. We'll see if we can make you cry more than the day Mashed Potatoes Vampire left you.
There you go, Bruce. Come on in. You have 2 minutes to come in, or I'm banning you.
But I'm not diminishing what they go through. But I'm saying,
then come in. If you're not Bruce, then come in and prove you're not Bruce. Like, it'd be easy. And then we'll say, okay, then you're not Bruce.
Nothing. What are you talking about? It's going to be hilarious when we find out. We know for a fact that you're Bruce. Like, we know.
Bruce.
It's not a real clinical fear. And it has variations in the definition.
Who is that?
That's Bruce.
Does he sound like a bitch? Yes, he does.
Like a bitch. He probably looks like a potatoes vampire, too.
Yeah.
Potato.
I wish we had everyone's got a picture of Bruce.
You can't take a picture of Bruce. He's got that,
Then click on the link, bitch.
It's just blurry, you know?
You got a lot of shit to say about me. You run your cocksucker. Click on the link. Here it is. I'll put it back in the thing. Don't worry about it. I got you.
You saw a video I had Bruce made. Shut the fuck up. Get in here. Get in here, you piece of shit.
All I have to do is click on it, and then, dude, I'm good.
Yeah, if you're really not Bruce, then it'd be like, oh shit, look, that's not Bruce.
Let me tell you guys something crazy. Bruce cried when this left him. He cried.
Who can say?
Next time Billy goes to the doctor, he'll have to see doctor now for my 600 lb life.
Thanks, buddy. I'm super happy that you said that. That's super nice of you. You're a great person.
Doc's going to be like, I told you, Billy, no more chicken nuggets. He can't quit them.
And don't right, here's put that what you on do. Shanny.
You get a side-by-side picture of Eugenia Cooney and Shanny. And you just let the audience place their bets. And you don't even have to say what it's for. We all know.
There you go. You're in timeout for 5 minutes until you join the link. You're not going to talk in the chat unless you're going to click the link, bitch.
If Bruce is afraid of getting teamed up on, I don't mind being put in the background while Billy and him hash things out. I'm assuming Bran...
I don't think it'd be the first time you've been teamed up on. Good.
I mean, I'll sit here and do my crosswords
again. I'll sit here and giggle.
I'll laugh at him for crying over losing mashed potatoes vampire.
I think I can just not interfere, but if he would feel better just him against Billy, you know, I'm just saying that I want the guests that come up to feel comfortable, you know what I mean?
Yeah, fucking Bruce, get in here and teach this hebophile a thing or two.
Here you go, the beast of me. This is the link for the third time, buddy.
Thank you.
A real gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand tea.
Billy is a nugget. Of what? I'll leave that to you.
Thanks, buddy. Nugget.
Enough is enough. And it's time for a change.
I don't understand tea.
And that's another thing, Sabella. You want to say shit about us, about me and the other mods, and how we weren't your friend or weren't there, whatever. We were the only friend that you fucking had.
How'd that work out for you?
It's going well.
You know what Sabella should do? She should start lying about Corky beating her and then take the money that Carrie's community gives her and go back to Bruce. That would be the heel turn of this century. I would be so happy.
What are you talking about? When you were going through all that shit, we were the only ones who had your back.
She wasn't going through any shit. She wasn't going through anything. Y'all just fucking gave her money because you're suckers.
These people.
That's why Kamal's there.
He's like, ooh, easy targets.
Let me just cozy up in here.
At you. Attacking you. Even though you were the one who was being abused. And we had your back.
Newsflash.
That's a lot of back to have.
And now you come out, and these people have done, you can say whatever you want about me, but these other mods and shit, they've never done anything to you. They've never done anything to you but be nice to you.
Mary Queen of Shots, what did I do? I'm washing my face.
We had your back when you went through all that, and then we had your back when you went and moved in with Nick, and you guys started your relationship, and we all supported you and said, that's wonderful, and if you...
And gave him money, but...
Paid for a ride.
Yeah. And now that clown is publicly owning you.
Pretty effectively, too, Jesus Christ.
You're happy, that's all that fucking matters.
Is she, though?
So explain to me, how could we have been a better friend than that? What is it that you did for me ever that was so fucking great and wonderful?
Wow, that's some super shanty vibes coming right from you there.
What have you done for me?
Yeah, there was a reason why she was simping for that bitch before any of this popped off.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but, like, I mean, well, Sabella was holding Corky back and saying, like, don't talk shit about her. And apparently that was actually a good thing because he's been dog walking you, so. Yikes, that was something.
Blast. You're saying you don't troll us, but what are you going to blast out from the speaker?
Are you ready? Don't get mad, okay?
Nigger, what are you gonna say, nigger?
No.
Jesus. Oh,
Jesus. Whoa. Christ.
J-dubs in rare form.
Well, yeah, it's not that rare. Damn.
Not at all.
J-dubs loves saying it. He loves saying it in Yiddish, too.
Jesus Christ.
It's like the whole entire reason he became Jewish is to say the N-word sneakily.
Don't get mad, all right?
Uh-huh.
That's what you got, huh?
What the fuck is that? What is it? I don't know what that is.
Unlike most of the cows, Vaughn actually doesn't watch the people that talk about him.
Fair.
Because watching people that talk about him is what made him look like this. And he knows it. Like, he insulates himself from people because he knows he's got about 3 more years left on this planet, and he could have about 30 more, but
he gave that up.
Aged the hell out of him.
He's very quickly becoming the fucking Crypt Keeper.
I wonder if the clone baby is going to show up to fuck Vaughn while he dies. It's a Hilton tradition.
Maybe his daughter will, because that wouldn't be gay.
That is.
Kid Larry said that
you had to visit your mom's gravesite. Is that because of what's on there that you don't approve of what's on the tombstone?
You want to talk about Larry? You want to talk about how scum the Frost are? How about burying Alice next to a damn dog?
Well, not only that, they buried her. Okay, listen, I did some research on this. They buried her backwards. Now you say, well, what does that mean? Okay,
you did some research. You weren't there when he dropped that bitch in the ground.
No, he didn't.
How the fuck do you know which direction she's going?
He has no interest. He just doesn't care. Like, you want to know why Vaughn didn't go to visit his mom in his mom's grave? Because he just doesn't give a shit.
He was busy moving into the double wad, you know? Very busy weekend. Fired one off at his mom and, you know.
Christian.
4 feet away from me did that. Okay, he fucking whacked off the horses.
Goodbye, horses.
Christian.
Well, here's the thing, okay? When you bury a body, in Christianity, you have to bury it so that it faces east because Christ is going to return in the east.
That's not
right?
True.
Well, I was doing some research
That's
on that.
That's not true.
And in old Vaughn,
you said that your gods are the real gods of creation, so why should any of that matter?
Shut up, hater.
Also not true.
Christianity, real old Christian.
He was right.
Like, you know,
maybe in very strict, like weird versions of Christianity, maybe, but
there's
probably some weird
before.
One. No.
Real old Christian. If you buried them facing west instead of east, you condemn them to wander the earth forever because they
can't rise
to meet Christ in the east.
Why? I'm pretty sure if they walked west far enough, eventually they'd arrive at their point anyway. So why are they wandering forever?
Nah, they're going to fall off the edge of the earth.
Oh, shit, that's right. No, they're just going to NPC walk into the ice cap wall.
And
know,
just keep
just
walking.
Over and over.
Yeah, you just fall off.
Forever going to wander the earth, I guess it's a disembodied spirit. And so it was a curse. It was a way to, it was a way to hurt someone in the ass.
He's been watching
now
the
she wasn't
anime.
Buried next to your dad?
No, dad's buried in Ohio. Dad was military. Dad's buried in Ohio with
daddy,
full military honors. Oh. And see, the Frost denied my mother of also, because see, my mother was a Rosie the Riveter. She stayed here in the States and built tanks and machine guns and bombs and shit for the war effort. She was working at Bendix and Whirlpool and some of these other factories that had been converted into building war machines. And so she was literally Rosie the Riveter. And if I understand correctly, which, you know, I mean, I could be wrong, but I don't think I am. But if I understand correctly, since she was Rosie the Riveter during World War II,
yeah,
she would have got full military honors minus.
So are you telling me that Rosie the Riveter was introduced to the Big Red One? Is that what you're telling me, Vaughn? Incredible.
He's saying that a civilian that works at a machine shop during war times.
Okay, there are a few common misconceptions about Christian burials. It is a myth that the Bible asked Christians to be facing east. It's believed that Christians adopted a practice burying their dead facing east because there are scriptures that state that Jesus will return first in the east by being buried with their feet facing towards the eastern horizon. The Christians could be ready to greet their Savior face to face. However, the Bible does not command followers to be buried facing east.
Oh yeah, Billy, we'll have you considered.
You are a bitch.
This was the first. No. The thing is, Vaughn Googled it and he read the first like the little header thing, and that was literally the myth part. And he didn't read on. You fucking idiot. That was easy.
Gun salute.
Well, I was wrong. Gonna get a 170 million.
She's not military.
Well, she was young. She had been like in her early teens, right? Like 13, 14.
I don't. Well, she can't be that fucking young. But
well, she'd have
yeah,
to
that's
because,
the point, Vaughn.
Okay, so.
Okay, now hold it. Now, damn it, my father's World War II is documented.
My bullshit's falling apart. Hold on.
I believe that 100%.
Okay, well, where the fuck is everybody getting this 13, 14 shit from?
Okay.
My parents would not have been that young. No
okay,
way.
Let me give you an example. My grandmother died. She was born in 1928, okay? Mm-hmm. That means that she would be, this year, she would have been 96, okay? Mm-hmm. So I think your mom would have been probably around 96 now if she was still alive or somewhere in that area,
no,
right?
No, she'd have been 92 or 3, I think.
All right, so you do the math.
But
born in 1928.
But you're not listening. Okay?
World War II ended in, or started in 1944, right?
Oh, Vaughn, you're not listening.
No, World War II did not start. World War II started in 1939, bro.
Well, okay.
World War II started in 1939, and America went into World War II in 1941.
Okay, yeah. I thought it was.
Yeah.
Bailey was single finger typing.
I think he's right.
Yeah, it's 39. He was right.
Like, I think the record book says 44 to 48, right? Or something like that?
No.
Okay.
World War II started in 1939 when Germany and
Go away, dog. I got to win this internet fight.
America joined World War II in 1941.
I'll stick you in a trash can later.
Oh, yeah, you're right. September 39.
I'm going to do some stickers.
A real gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand, too.
Jello, enjoy the video of Billy I sent you.
Ooh. Something for the old spank bank, I see.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Bro, man,
and then America joined in World War II in 1941 because of the attack on Pearl Harbor.
Nah. Gotcha.
The days that we're living in.
You are a bitch.
I wonder if he said anything, huh? Refresh.
You can watch how slow Frank computer is. That's cool.
Him and his totally not also him girlfriend are having an amazing conversation.
So I'm fucking laughing my ass off. It's gonna be so funny as hell when the geek room finds out I'm not Bruce. We don't care if you are or not. You probably kill yourself. That's going to be hilarious. Just proof. Wait, there are a bunch of dumb leftists who will believe anything.
Hey,
they believe Nick Bravo.
I'm no leftist.
Okay, wait a minute. Frank, does it have the upload date of that video that Bruce posted on the channel?
I think so. Hold on.
Like, I know it's unlisted, but does it still have the upload date? Because if this was a video that he's claiming he just like recently had him make for him, it wouldn't it stand to reason that it would not be very old.
Did he take it down?
We're gonna see if,
did he take it down? Hold on. I know where I can see it on
the screen.
It wasn't Bruce, please, but it's gone now.
Get rid of your screen share if you're not going to have the thing. Don't dox anything, you dumb fuck.
I thought it just did it.
You did not.
Silly.
Now I know you're a Loki fan, fuckhead.
Ah, got me.
It wouldn't be weird enough. That's stupid. Loki sucks.
You suck.
Got him.
Who this? Who's this?
It is on the... He did private it. So your private video.
Somebody brought up the fact that Frank had a folder called All the Children.
All in the family.
Children.
Hold on.
Keep on screaming.
If you scrub back in the screen, it's at the
bottom. Oh, no, I still got the screenshot of it because I figured he would take it down.
Sound proof the walls.
Who is this person backstage? Hello, person.
Can we like put something on the screen because I don't feel like
I don't know you.
Hi, how's it going, Kazoom?
Well, hello.
Kazoom.
Hi, Kazoom.
Kaboom.
Hello, Kazoom. Who are you?
I'm doing all right. How about you?
I said, who are you?
Who am I? How do I define that? How does anyone define that?
What if we're going to solipsism? Because if you're doing that, you're the most unhinged idiot who does not know how to fucking do any philosophy.
That's not
philosophy 101 bullshit. And it's like somebody just went to the first course and you're like, dude, just end it. Eventually,
I've made comments in the side chat. I don't see why you're being so weird. So
it's
I'm
Billy.
Always weird.
It's weird. It's Billy.
Are you that fucking unhinged idiot?
No, that's not.
I don't know whether I'm an. It depends on your perspective, I suppose.
Oh God, I'm gonna kill myself, Kazoom. Okay.
He's trying to be fair. Look, if you
Billy
said
can't
that
deal
to
with
me,
it.
I'd be like, probably. Oh,
I can't deal with. Are you the fucking it's a beast dipshit? You know.
No, that's not. That's not.
No, no, okay. I'm not. No, I don't even know what that is. So.
Who are you?
I'm just a guy. I'm just a guy on the internet.
There you go. Say that, fucker. My brain hurts right now. I talked to G-Man today.
I mean, probably the thing I'm the most known for is doing the voice work for JCS Criminal Psychology.
Who the fuck is that?
All right.
Billy likes sausage.
No. Who is that? I don't know who that is.
That's a channel that has to do with criminal psychology. So they've got like 5 million subscribers. So
that's pretty dope. Mm-hmm. What, like, what do you mean criminal psychology? What do you mean, like
people who have committed murder, mass murder? It's describing the psychology behind some of the worst people imaginable. So,
has Frank on it?
Who?
Says the heapophile.
I like this game now.
I fucking hate kids.
Nah, I think you put the fuck in the wrong place in that sentence.
Oh, thank you so much for being on this channel, Brian, what the fucker name?
You're welcome. Who the fuck am I? My newbie. Who invited? It's fucking Brian's coming. God damn it.
So do you watch the channel there? Cause
yeah, for a while I was even I even was I joined the channel for a while, but you do focus on very particular things for a long time. So, but this time I thought it was appropriate to come on. So,
Kazoom is old school. Come on, man. All right, Pep.
I don't know anyone from the old school, dude.
I hung out with Kazoom on G+.
Yes, ooh, yes. I was a big... I loved G+. That was a great platform.
It depends on,
The only thing I liked about G+ more is the cows were more intuitive to deal with people. Now they're
that's true.
Very insular these days.
You remember me, don't you, Kasum?
I can't see your name, so I don't know.
Jello.
Jello. Oh, yes, for sure. Yes, absolutely.
You've been to my house.
Man, you sound a lot.
Yes, I've been,
you sound
I've been
like
to your house. Yes, absolutely.
Whoa, Kazoom.
You've been
what
to
is
the
it?
Garage?
What did it smell like?
Cigarettes.
That's it, man. That's probably not wrong.
Man, it's great to see you, Jello. I didn't know you were even around on these internet stuff. So yes, that's
unfortunately,
great.
He's still here. Just offending people still.
Just
day.
Offending people left and right. That's what I do.
Nerdy and
but
Spicy.
If you
was
ever
a
need $150, I got you.
Nerdy and Spicy was as a member for 35 months. Billy was a dick for no good reason. LOL. Don't be a Billy.
And you love me, so shut up.
And Isolationist A for $1. Of course Vaughn knows Nazi history correctly. Fair.
Yeah. Fucking yikes. that's
fair,
like the
Billy's
best way to put it.
Dick.
Dude, I thought we actually had a tard come up and I was excited. Now I just have a normal person.
So that's why you got that from Billy, by the way.
I was so excited for a tard.
He took out his frustrations in not having a tard on you. That's what that was.
Yeah, he's got
I'm sorry.
Kazoo, do you have any shitty opinions that I can make fun of?
You like a flat earther or anything?
No, I'm not a flat earther. What? And like my opinions on trans issues would probably, I don't know how that would be taken. So.
Who invited Steve McRae's friend on here?
Oh, shit. Oh, no.
Oh, no. This is an old guy with a white beard, isn't it?
It's British Steve McRae.
British?
What? Wait, what?
Okay.
He sounds slightly foreign. I can't
just
tell.
Eloquent.
What? That's foreign to me.
Silly.
What the hell?
Foreign,
you,
foreign
you
eloquence.
Get out of Florida.
No, not Florida.
You gotta get out of Florida, man.
No,
I'm gonna
man.
Have to quit joking about
we
you.
We love banning being... books down here. What's that?
I'm gonna have to quit joking about you being dumb. Boy. Shit's getting too real.
I understand, T.
Enjoy next week private show, Tubby.
Woo!
What the fuck did you send?
They must be talking to you guys. That's gotta be for Billy.
If it's the private show, I'm scared though.
Send and release.
It is a private show.
Oh God, what did it?
What is it then?
I got something that Hatman sent me, but. Teddy Gimli just sent me something. I'm just kind of.
Yeah, don't play it on screen.
Yeah, I'm not going
right
to do
now.
That.
I know, but you're pretty dumb.
It says the person that just made that comment just like 2 seconds ago.
You don't even remember what the comment was.
That's because he's dumb.
Yeah.
Yeah, at least
two things we got in common, Billy.
Frank, you sound foreign.
Jesus Christ, don't say two! Oh, gross.
Once they graduate out of Frank's basement, they go directly to Billy's.
Yeah, don't
say moist.
Alright, fuck. Do you fucking have your middle school diploma? Frank's done with you.
And Billy's just starting.
And if you're gonna say moist, never, never say with sticky.
When moist becomes crunchy.
That's why it's gray.
I hate this channel.
There's people still watching us for some reason.
I'm voting for our dad.
Good, I will.
Infamy.
Well, alrighty then.
Yes. 41. And like I said, you know, there's no fucking way in hell. My dad and mom were 13 goddamn years old when World War II started, because neither
yeah,
one of
point.
Them would have went to war.
Well, check this out. If your mom was born in 20, if your mom's born in 28, and it started in 39, that's only 11 year difference. That's only 11 years, right? So, but if you start doing the math, Are you saying that maybe you're...
There's something wrong. You know, see, you got to remember, okay, the frog had a for their damn lawyer.
You're saying she's born... She's old. You're saying she's older. She's older than what they say.
People aren't supposed to do math while I'm talking. God damn it!
Something's wrong.
Listen. Okay, a Kentucky congressman can do a lot of shit. He can have documents hidden, frozen, changed.
What?
He can do all kinds of shit. It's untelling what all they've been fucking doing behind the scenes.
A Kentucky congressman had it hidden when World War II actually began?
Or when his mom died?
I suppose.
Or when his mom was born?
Or how old she was when the war started?
I guess that'd be born.
Nah, just move the war.
That's just fucking stupid.
Vaughn, you're a lot better off arguing child labor laws. It was the 30s. They allowed 11-year-olds to work in bomb factories.
Right? Could have said that.
Like, anything would have been smarter than this.
I don't know. That mini stroke he had was pretty good. I liked it.
When he was inside his mom?
Oh, that wasn't a mini stroke, little Bill. He gave it all he had.
That was all his strokes.
All 2.5 inches.
Every last inch and a half.
Are you sure you want to be up here in this mess, Kazoom?
All is Vaughn, well. That's all good. So
Vaughn fucked his dying mom.
Yeah. They both stroked out simultaneously.
He was coming, she was going.
Entered World War II at 13 goddamn years of age. No fucking way. Sorry.
Do that first fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand, T.
Yes, Frank, how bad is it? Hash, where's refried beans?
I keep forgetting about that video.
And I implore you to continue to forget about it.
I don't understand, T.
Oh, Anna Manager's in the chat. I think I'm getting confused for you.
Nope.
Someone's confusing me with you.
Nope.
Like, look at that Mr. Beast, whatever the fuck his name is.
Nope, it's Billy.
It didn't fucking happen. So either the
Mr. Beast calls you a hebophile?
That'd be dope. That'd be really beneficial to the channel.
Or whatever. Or maybe fucking CERN turned her damn machine on.
Maybe
there it is. CERN changed her age.
Than your mom?
No.
Turning the transcription machine off.
No. My parents
did that,
were very
did you just do a
age,
fucking
not,
okay.
Did you just do a voiceover?
I suppose.
My brain hurts.
Your butt hurts.
My brain hurts.
I was
his
there.
His brain is in his butt.
That's true.
I mean, yeah.
I was really expecting a tired. God.
He's so disappointed.
He can't sit up straight without the blood rushing to his head.
Thanks, buddy.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
But you know, but
the blood
people
is
remember
to
you.
His butt.
A real gentleman would do that.
People remember Jell-O Fawn.
Are you Brainy Beaver or just Canadian?
I don't think this is Brainy Beaver.
I think it's just yes. The answer is yes.
Wait, are they saying Canadians are smart? That's
no, you don't remember Brainy Beaver? You don't remember Brainy Beaver?
No.
Brainy Smurf.
He was like a flat earth debunker guy.
I remember Brainy Smurf.
No, different guy, I think.
King Way in hell, my parents went to war at 13 like goddamn years old. No, they didn't. That's
I mean,
bullshit.
I agree.
That's bullshit. Okay?
Man, flat earthers are the most insane. You can't... There's no logic or reason that you can give them that will make them change their minds. It's stupid.
It is really dumb.
It's funny when they make videos and accidentally disprove their own ideas.
God. Yes. So yes, it is.
Like Beyond the Curve, that when the very end really went, that's interesting, and then it went to black. That shit was hilarious. That was a good-ass movie.
So funny.
Oh yeah, that video
he
was
spent
made about a month ago.
$15,000 on a gyroscope.
What's that, Frank? That video was made a month ago?
Yeah.
That's interesting there, Boost.
Who's confusing Anna for Billy? They actually know how to run a show.
Don't no, bring me down, Bruce.
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 Kizum, can you do a vo saying Boba Fett is dead?
Don't. Fett is dead. Bruce. Bruce.
Kill him. Kill him now.
He got that for
Bruce.
I like what you said about Boba Fett. True original.
I like what you said about you dying.
Kill him.
Kill him now.
Here, let's see. Got that. Kinda. Let's see if you can see it. Why does it set down that low? Shit.
I think Bruce is a liar.
I thought you had a screenshot of that, Frank.
I don't have it all the way down. I just had a screenshot of who did it.
Gender equality in America.
Did we have Texas speech on?
Gotta get Dave to talk about this.
Yep, 1 month ago.
Oh, dude, then yeah, you're definitely Bruce. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah, stop lying. Quit it. You cried over mashed potatoes vampire, and you know it.
Mashed potatoes vampire.
Vent mashed potatoes and the Devil's Tower.
Kazoon, do you remember?
Devil's Tower.
Kazoon, do you know of Sabella Summers, I guess?
I've heard of Sabella, but I don't know. I don't
she
know of
been
them.
Around at that time.
Yeah. I don't know of Sabella very much beyond what people post about her, so.
What about Shannon? Did you have any interactions with Shannon back in the day?
Not much.
Kazoom used to get
some, but not much.
Kazoom used to get annoyed when we'd sit in their G+ talking about Shannon. Back in those days, around 2015 or so, Sabella was big in Shannon's
verse.
She was like a mod and stuff.
I mean, she's in any verse.
All right.
And all the multiverses.
What about Steve McCray? Did you fuck with him at all? Or, like, what was going on there? Did you know that guy?
I have seen people... The main thing I know about Stephen McCray is that he says things that offend people a lot, but I've never actually looked into why he offends people so much. So, yeah, I'm not very well-versed on that, so...
His main thing is the definition of atheism... And that 0.9999 repeating doesn't equal one.
Yeah, but right. The Applebee's parking lot kicked his ass, so he's no threat.
Also, he picked up used condoms for rent.
What?
As you do.
Yeah, he did that. It's not even a joke.
Mm-mm.
Mm-hmm. That's the sentence.
I just know that just about everyone who has been known in the atheist community, just about everyone that has been the most known, have something negative associated with them. And I'm not saying that that's valid, but I just know that that's the way that things have gone, so.
It's pretty valid with that dude. Typically it's not, but it's pretty valid with that guy.
I mean, look, you got... The amazing atheist with the whole banana scandal.
Bananas.
Nah, as Jello struggles to find another atheist.
That one chick that fucking got into it with Gary. What's her fucking name? She was from Seattle.
The Bionic Dance?
Bionic Dance.
Okay, yeah. Her.
She was
her, all babies are atheist. Bionic Dance, yes.
Yeah, there you go. Like I think he's kind of right. I think they've all been somewhat problematic. Well, maybe not Thunderfoot. Thunderfoot's just a science guy. I don't think there's anything.
Somewhat. He does try to invalidate a number of other things, but I think they're valid. I think the things that he invalidates are valid, so...
don't know. I haven't.
What I maybe I God didn't damn. Word that right. I think the things that he thinks are invalid are also invalid. I
oh,
didn't.
You're saying you agree
I'm,
with him?
I, no, I'm not. I agree with him. Yes, I agree with him. Yes.
Oh, I remember that too, Andreas.
I mean, he's taken some people who have tried to put out some bullshit products, and he's shitted all over them, and I think that's great. There needs to be more of that.
Brett Keane was a pretty prominent atheist back in the day. He was pretty problematic, right? There's definitely
yes, but once he switched over back to theism, he sucked. Everything he says sucks. It's just it's pathetic. He doesn't even deal with atheist arguments. He deals with straw men from atheist arguments. It's stupid.
Basically, but he's regarded. Oh shit! Did I talk over a super chat?
Nah, you're good. I think you're gonna hear it.
Well, Brett Keane also, while he was an atheist, did plagiarize that poem.
And he did listen to his son have sex.
So, yep. I mean,
he's been awful the whole time around. It doesn't matter what mindset he has; he sucks.
Yeah.
Really, he sucks.
I do remember one time he was supposedly about to get kicked out of his home, and the exact amount of money he was requesting was the total of his Amazon wish list.
Oh man. Oh fuck me. That is great.
Yeah.
Damn.
That's impressive.
I remember this part with
come on, take notes.
Her trying his feed. This is gonna be a funny video, I think.
Someone's calling you. What the fuck? Joshy got a booty call. Oh, you're still. Oh, shit.
Oh, fuck. Mr. Burns is going to try some of the mead.
Smithers.
Fuller.
Now, does anybody know what this mead is?
This is the spicy mead, right?
This is the hot honey habanero mead.
Oh, he already he made that one. Okay.
Yeah, this is the one he made in prep for her coming down.
I didn't watch.
So, is it like a fuck you mead?
Pretty much. If you're making spicy anything, you want to be sure to give it to your guest to taste first. That's the way to go to work that angle.
That's silly. Joshy in his booty calls. The booty was so big it made it knock over.
That's how we got a burn to it.
Okay. Yeah, you fucking filled mine up, Buttercup. Well, give me a little cheers, but don't knock me. I've already
got a spicy burn to it.
I've already spilled some on me. I can smell the habanero.
Yeah, there's definitely enough habanero in this. Oh, simple dude.
There's
sipping meat.
I think she just said a prayer.
She cast a spell of protection over her stomach.
Sip will do it. It's the sipping meat.
Does he like have...
She's saying a prayer right there. That's what
she's staggering.
So is he like having sex or what?
Yeah.
With this
you
thing.
Did it live.
Yeah, you got to see a silhouette show.
Oh my, no, I didn't know about that, so.
It's on Twitter, apparently.
That's for the best.
Probably.
I'm good. It can stay on Twitter.
they may or may not also have had a fist fight on camera.
Yeah.
All right.
I'd watch that. Wow,
I pulled the video last night. I don't know if Billy went over it.
It's really hard because it just points up at the ceiling and you kind of see a shoulder of it now and then. It's not really it's not definitive. It's muted. You can't even hear if they're yelling at each other or not.
Sweet.
But she was on a bender. Per perfect.
He nailed it, Josh.
That was the littlest sip.
I added hot honey to it because it was dumbed down on the heat when I added it.
That is the face of somebody questioning some life choices.
Yep. What did she do?
Josh, he's spilling all over yourself, baby.
I was coughing and I filled the glass too fast.
And you're drooling. Don't let me get my baby, because I do care about my fucking mead. No.
Anything to get out of drinking that mead.
Josh had a spicy as fuck.
Stop giving him the vitamins. God, he can't even talk.
And
yeah, he should probably get more vitamins.
A little sample, baby.
I didn't realize it was maybe that spicy.
You should have given me a little sample, baby. I didn't need a whole glass of this.
So you don't even need to take like a gulp, just a little baby sip. That is
as much as you want. We'll just dump it back in the jar. I wanted to see how it was fermenting.
Oh, Joshy.
Suddenly I farted.
Jesus Christ.
Way, he's sick with some unknown, like, head cold or flu or something. So he wants to dump the thing back in the mead, the mead jar after she's been drinking off of it.
I'm getting some heavy wet brain rev, like, vibes here.
Mm-hmm. Like she's in the middle of trying to give him wet brain.
It's the vitamins. It's just the vitamins.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I'm just, this is some early Rev and Shanny shit going on here.
She gives him vitamins. He takes a little nap on the couch. You know, it's all good.
Vitamins. You're probably molesting.
And why are you such an ugly fucking whore? I mean, I know your dad fucks your ass, and then after he gets all of your shit on his dick, he fucking makes you suck his dick afterward. But if Josh wanted to do better, I'm sure he could, but he gave me a chance. So suck your daddy's shit-filled fucking cum dick. Thank you.
Isn't she lovely?
She's a shit-filled
cum dick. I'm going, okay, all right.
I thought it would be a shit-covered. I didn't know it would be filled.
Yeah.
Yeah, filled with is kind of weird.
Yeah, that's like Cyrax territory at that point.
Like the weirdest kind of sounding I ever heard of.
When she gets mad at people in her chat, she does a lot of
raging
incest insults. Like you're.
Oh yeah.
It's kind of a go-to for her, and you know what people say about when Cyrax does it? Now it's probably projection.
What did she do?
She's just trying to watch him face.
Oh shit!
God, he's out of the basement.
Like a body, my same size.
He's in public,
including into me.
He has wheels
and hair.
Public.
He drives a truck for a living, Billy.
Does he?
He drives publics for a
Takes the groceries.
That's not good.
I'm just glad he has pants on. That's, you know.
Do we know he has pants
on? Yeah.
It's a good assumption.
Is it?
I'm hoping.
Greetings. God entered into my body like a body my same size.
Like me floating into you,
you floating into me. When I touch my skin, I feel electricity going up my hands. Kind of like a fire burning that you can't see.
Do you drink some of Cobes' mead too?
Touching.
But it's not a fire.
Feels like you got some of the vitamins.
It's not a fire. It's just touching.
Anyway.
I gotta find the book, man. I got it somewhere.
You still have that thing?
I do. Well, somebody fucking sent me money. I'm not gonna throw it out.
Not fair.
I'd feel bad.
You know what? Whoever sent the money, I'm pretty sure they wouldn't care if you throw that out and just like burn it.
I did the review of it. It was hard to review because it was one long run-on sentence.
Well, that's because God never entered your body like a body, your same size, like me floating into you or you floating into me.
It was just verbal diarrhea. It was just
verbal defecation.
Thank you.
Another old gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand, T.
Why was Father J in there?
What was...
My skin feels electric a little bit. It feels like I'm tingling, vibrating, moving.
An electric toilet.
Don't you want to put your hands all over me?
No.
Negative. No electric toilet for you.
No. I would let you. Anyway, the Bible says God knows all things. That's what it says.
I love the transition.
Now, does God really know all things?
Like who?
I want to ask you a question. Does God know today what the winning lottery numbers are going to be on Tuesday? There's no way. There's no way God could know.
The only way, future and past, he would know.
He's omniscient, motherfucker.
Yeah, isn't that the omniscient, omnipotent?
Yeah. Are you sure God passed into your body like a body your same size, like you floating into me or me floating into you?
Well, you know, he doesn't think of it as a good thing.
I hate that you do that so much.
God damn it.
Dude, God. Even doing that on your fucking tombstone, I'm going to have that put. You smoke and I don't, so I'll be here.
That's not true.
Don't you vape still?
Yeah, you said smoke.
Yeah, I'm fine. I don't do any of that shit.
But you don't eat vegetables.
Right.
No, I don't think Brandon has the healthiest of diets either, motherfucker.
I'm not going to die trying to shit. Billy.
Crush the boots.
You're actually like fucking Brand's over there making sure he's looking at the pyramid every day. Like, did I get this shit in here?
My name is Bran.
Or organic vegetables.
All organic.
What was that, Brian?
I said, as the new guy.
Just hired.
Good old what's his name?
Riffs.
Yes, this is a Kazoom on panel. Sam?
Did accurately tell what those numbers is going to be is...
Sam, if you want the link, I can send it to you. If you're not doing anything.
Yeah, we can send you the link. It'll be like floating into you. You're same size.
He make up numbers right now and then supernaturally get involved in letting those numbers fall through the little hole out of that little machine they spend. God can make a ball that would normally fall through that hole not fall through it. He can make it float. He can make an unseen wall appear to keep it from going through and only let the ones that he tells you is going to come through.
He made an unseen bowl appear on your head.
There's no way that God knows what the lottery numbers on Tuesday and Wednesday is going to be.
Crustables is what we call Billy's underpants. Please, someone help us. Thank you, Billy's right at butt cherry.
Wasn't there a product called the Uncrustables?
Yeah.
There is still a product called the Uncrustables.
About the crust.
They're amazing. All right.
That is true, Undraven. It's the same link.
Does God know how many miles your car engine will last? No way. He can say it's going to last 180,000 miles, and he can make it go out at 180,000 miles. But if he leaves it alone, there is no way he could know. Does God know when you're going to die? No.
And there's the Sam.
No one ever knows when they're going to die. I mean, what is this point?
Hopefully soon.
Except you.
Doing well.
God can make you die.
They're doing well. Biden's stock market has been lit.
Oh, now you're going.
Not according to the Beast and me.
Yeah, he's going to make a comment about you now.
Ooh.
Maybe
Ooh.
You're addicted to 17-year-olds too.
Wait, what? What
just happened? Billy. It's just Billy. Don't worry about
it. Did Sam completely miss it?
I'm
apparently I'm a pedo now.
No. Get it right.
Whatever the other one is.
A Fembophile?
Yeah, the one you are, Billy.
Fucking Frank's loving this. Just a this is such a Mikey is someone besides me.
This is such a turn in how my night was going. I feel like this is I literally like you can victim blame in this situation. Like I knew what I was walking into.
Yeah, no, you know. And you click
I'm
the.
I'm glad you're here. I got this weird thing on my shoulder. I want to show you after.
Not that type of doctor.
God damn it!
He can say you're gonna die at age 80, and then when you hit age 80, he can make you die. But if he doesn't mess with you, it's predictable. But nobody can guess exactly when you're going to die. The Bible says God knows all things. Those things he doesn't know. There's a lot of other things he doesn't know. Now, how does God know the end
like from the beginning? Like where a decent barber is?
The beginning from the end? Well, God has the same heart you have. God made you exactly like he is. That means
no, Billy,
God
I think
is
his
like...
mom died, and then God floated into her for a few.
Do you think he had the bowl cut when he applied for the job?
Yes.
How does that interview work?
Well, he's a truck driver, so they're like, whatever gets him out of the office and into the general public away from us.
God damn it, Tadit.
What do Sam and Destiny have in common? They're 5'3". Brag about a quarter of an inch and lost their girl to something hung like a horse.
Damn.
I can't even come back. That is...
You can't even argue that. It's just facts.
You. God is like all the bad people.
I've graduated from horse chiropractor to dog trainer. I informed Billy today.
Whatever, just so long as you make the sexy videos.
Not.
Got close.
That ever was. And God is like all the good people that ever was. And it is not in.
I'm going to the next one.
God damn it, you little Jap bitch!
Yep. Right off the
Jesus.
Right off the bat.
Is he doing commentary on someone playing a wrestling
no,
game?
No, he's playing.
Oh, okay. I really want Bran to do a Let's Play video series so I can do commentary on it.
I did some back in the day. Not so much anymore.
Oh, boy.
Damn it, you fucking bitch! You little whore!
Why is it so funny to watch him be fucking belligerent and sexist to fucking video game characters?
Because the one thing you think he'd be good at is video games.
He's not.
Nope.
I thought he'd be good at domestic abuse.
Nobody ever gave him the chance.
Yeah, I was waiting for it. Thank you, Brian.
Why is it not surprising to me that he's into wrestling?
Wrestling.
Dude, he's got the game out and everything, bro.
Okay. Go to the outside!
What's that?
Do you have this one?
No, I haven't owned a wrestling game in like 15 years.
Okay.
I had one of the 2Ks, but I haven't really been a fan of the way the campaign works.
I tried one of the UFC games. I'm like, this is way too much for me.
There's a lot.
A lot of blood.
Do not have the brain power to learn those
there
controls.
There's a lot going
and
on.
The UFC game, if you do like the interviews before the fights and shit like that, you start talking shit, the game makes you lose. Like you're getting your fucking ass kicked. I basically go up to the fight like respectless, like, fuck, yes, sir. And then beat the fuck out of
him. Yeah, you're probably going to beat me.
And then I win. What's up?
shut all her haters up.
God fucking damn it!
So mad. I think the funniest thing about this is just like, this is completely voluntary, dude. You don't have to have this on stream.
Yeah, this is supposed to be an escape for you.
All right.
Like, how bad is his regular life that this is his escapism?
Fucking game! Not hell bad!
I don't understand getting angry at a video game. Like, I was trying to do honor mode on Baldur's Gate 3, and you know, it's like Iron Man. It's hardcore. If you guys die, it's over, you know?
Yeah.
And like on like attempt number 12 in like a week's time, I was like, fuck. And I just turned it off. And I haven't tried since. But I didn't yell and scream. I didn't get like I was like, okay, I've put enough time into this and I just like can't.
Ruining dog's birth system doesn't count as dog training. Whose voice is high now, bitch?
Your voice is still high and you missed that. I went on a date with a dog trainer today. That isn't obviously not my dog.
Did you bring the peanut butter or did they already have it?
They already had it. But thank you for asking.
Of course.
Is it that hell-bent that my goddamn creative star can't fucking get a title?
What the fuck?
He made himself and he lost the title. That's what he said.
Is this what happens when you haven't had sex for 10 years?
Yes.
Or ever?
I don't know, man. I got a friend that hasn't had sex in almost about that amount of time, and he's not this mad.
Dave's mom's got to hurry up and pass away.
Like, I've never gotten, like even during a dry spell.
Gross.
Like,
I hate you for that one.
There's no stuff in the Cretans from out there.
Cretan.
Cretan.
Gotta go for a world
with a person who fails to develop mentally and physically.
Derogatory.
An idiot.
Creator.
It's missing.
Yep.
I'm a good woman, like Crystal Lee characters. I'm not playing. I think it's.
Oh, did y'all play the little clip I put in yesterday?
The
pissing?
One where she was needing the toilet paper and Leslie was just chilling.
Yeah.
Why does she look 37 and 7 years old at the same time?
Oh God, that's Frank's preference.
Is that just me?
Yeah, you skipped Billy's age there, so this is a Frank joke area. He didn't say 17, so.
Yeah, this looks like fucking Billy would. Billy would hit on her, and then Jella would try to disappoint her afterwards.
No, Frank is the kid diddler.
No.
Mine is if you have your driver's license already, apparently.
Restricted.
Because you don't want to listen.
I know you're a
girl. And I still want to do karate. I'm not kidding when I get a better place to live. Right now we're almost homeless because the way we are and because of a lot going on because Grandpa is letting Keith do drugs with my group in a retirement home to let you know, Brian. And this guy named Bob Lister is doing drugs with my brother and I don't like drugies, like I said. That's the truth. You get money, can you help us though?
Is that just a pile of junk food on the bed?
Yes.
Yeah, it is.
Just like also, soda and candy and...
Also, shout out to I'm Not Crystal Station. If you're a fucking mod, please put their link in their chat, please. Thank you.
$100, somebody, send it to my Cash App.
Yeah,
my phone. That's why I do the Cash App.
Okay, hurry. I need my phone.
Okay, they can't hear it. That's the wrong Cash App. You need to quit it now.
I want to watch videos on my phone. I'm bored. Please, I'm online bored.
Well, this is more important right now. I don't care.
You have your other phone, Crystal.
You're going to kill me.
Okay.
You're going to give me a stroke.
Okay. I don't think I'll ever kill you. No.
I can feel it. Oh.
She can feel the stroke coming.
You feel it. Because that's how it works.
Can you die from that, Crystal? You're young.
Because a baby can die from a stroke or a heart attack. Look it up.
I didn't know that. So you use my phone. Oh, no, you take it from me every day. I know.
I'm having a sad off.
He doesn't understand life without his phone.
He doesn't understand tea.
I'm bored, Crystal.
I don't quite understand this dynamic because at once, like, he is less pathetic than Rev and more pathetic.
Oh, yeah.
I love that her phone is charging right there on the bed 2 feet away from her. Yeah, and its screen is on. She can use it while it's charging. She can, but no, she'd rather let that charge and use his phone while he sits there working.
So doesn't she have two phones already because she's streaming on one phone?
This is important, Bran.
Here's a stroke coming on, buddy. What's up?
Read that super chat.
Oh, what does it say? Sister Billy wants to learn jujitsu.
Like Billy's sister? No, she's not like...
Apparently that's my sister on screen.
You know, you guys are killing. It doesn't seem skinny enough
to be your sister.
No, not skinny enough.
You guys are wasting a great opportunity. You got a decent voice on panel. Put Kazoom to work.
I think he went to the bathroom.
Yeah. I think so, too.
$70 phone.
Don't you bet you're hiding something. That's why.
No, I'm not. You just looked at my phone. I'm not cheating.
Leave me alone now. I'm busy.
Can I get my phone? Are you done yet?
No, I'm trying to find the
I had to charge it and everything, too. I'm walking out of here.
There you go. Then if you go, I call the cops.
Call the cops.
You're my husband. I know I am. Amen.
I'll tell the cops you think I'm cheating because I'm little retards on the fucking phone.
I don't believe them right now. I'm busy with the cash.
They're fucking scantless lowlife. Fucking judging me. Say I'm a fucking druggie. Leslie down there doing drugs. You maybe do drugs, little retard.
He definitely keistered something, Crystal.
You maybe do drugs.
The bad ones, not the good people. We're not talking about
The ones are good on here. I respect.
A real gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand T.
She looks like the daughter from Hereditary.
Yes, she does. Oh, my God.
Oh, man. Keith Heyman's coming to this family, huh?
The one that put me down or fucking retard.
Leslie's gonna leave. That's what Mars said. You're gonna leave Mars and you're gonna leave me.
Mars said that?
Yeah.
Mars is telling you you need to stop accusing me. I'm a good guy. I've never heard you.
Hey, Mars, you're the whore cheater, Mars. Corny don't cheat. You do. She's married. You're not. You're married to a he, she, and a he. That girl you're with, she's ugly, Mars. What do you date a woman that's ugly, looks like a man, a she? Then you're fucking your own husband. That's sick. You don't do that, do you? Parasocial don't do that. You know that, Leslie. And Jared Black don't do that.
Nobody don't like the look.
I don't care. I'm blocking you, Mars.
Don't do that.
Bro, he's in mid-cry.
I don't like people that are he-she. Courtney, she's okay. Courtney, you're okay. Like me. We're faithful to our man. Amen. The truth, Mars, I never liked you, the truth. I like Courtney way more, Mars.
Oh!
She's okay. Courtney, you're like me. We're faithful to our man. Amen. The truth, Mars, I never liked you, the truth. I like Courtney way more, Mars.
Oh!
What happened there?
I think he probably bit his own tongue or something stupid.
I think those noodles a little too hot.
He's been eating it though, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Maybe.
I don't understand.
I feel like these are the types of people that get into altercations at Piggly Wiggly's.
They are definitely the one.
Oh man, come near
Frank
one of those.
Sounds like, very fucking knowledgeable.
I feel like that part of my family that I gets to fight at funerals.
You definitely see this at the Piggly Wiggly.
Frank, we got to go hang out at the Piggly Wiggly if this shit's going on.
I'm bringing the camera.
Uh-huh. I'm just trying to figure out if they're related to Frank or Bran.
Yes.
Well,
column A.
Is one grabbing a rat goo? As if it is, it's not related to Bran.
Nope. That's how you know there's no Schneiders around here.
Is there still Piggly Wigglies out there?
I don't know. Maybe.
I don't know if you know this from the sound of my voice and the fact that, like, I sound like white privilege, but I don't, I've never been to a Piggly Wiggly.
Because you are walking, talking.
Oh, if you ever come down here, we find a Piggly Wiggly, we're definitely taking you one.
If you ever come down here.
If you ever come down here, I'll take you what?
Take way you down here, Piggly Chattahoochee.
The closest Piggly Wiggly to me is in New York State, but yes, they do still exist.
Huh.
Well, goddamn.
Who knew?
Mars, you cheat. I don't. You don't even know me, Mars. I'm like Cherry Block from Peckham. I don't cheat. And Mars says she don't cheat. Yeah, she does. Poor Mars. You're like Desiree Mars. And you never look good like me. You don't know yoga or push-ups or sit-ups or squats. I do. Paris motherfucking Hilton. And you know she
obviously
don't.
You
she's
do.
Like 300 pounds. I'm like 100 something. I weigh like 185. That's the real me. You want a real woman like that, don't you?
Yes, but you ain't for cheating me, because I would never cheat on you.
He's still...
What?
What is that?
He sounded like he was chewing on marble.
No, I don't. Look, no armpits. I have no hair under my armpits. That's never... I shaved them. Look.
No, you do.
And you show up close moles. More. See?
No.
I shaved my armpits the other day. That's deodorant, to let you know.
I love you.
See?
Make a personal aesthetic choice.
No hair under my armpits. I do not. They're saying I have hair under my armpits.
No, you don't. Look in the mirror, prison jet.
They're just saying that to me.
You know I would never.
I mean, if you have hair under your armpits, and there's a, I don't know, there if you have. Holy shit! I'm gone.
Chicken tenders.
If you are obese, you will have eventually dark under your armpits, and it's not a good thing.
Is it like the dark on the knuckles?
I don't know.
Billy, can you explain this to me? I don't understand what's going on.
I don't understand it either.
The dark on the knuckles is a sign of diabetes. Diabetes.
Oh, maybe.
Diabetes.
I want my phone at 1 feet on board. I would never. I want to marry you. And you.
Emergency for what?
He was struggling to get all that out.
You know I would never.
I know that the star.
I want my phone at 1 feet on board. I would never. I want to marry you.
Just give me my phone.
Emergency for what, Uncle Barron? Who are you? Say emergency three times.
I love Crystal. Always will love it.
Gotta get that off my mind. So someone please cash up us like $1,000 or $800 or $900 to get a place to live at Chandler Crossings. Please, emergency. Yes, but wait.
Oh, shit. That's all you need? Fuck, I'm on it.
I got you, yeah.
Do earlier. You made me all mixed up. What was it? It's really important now.
I don't know what it was. I don't remember.
Why are you making me yell? I'm not my mom. I'm not Carla the bitch. The druggie.
Right, yeah.
I'm not Sandra the ugly whore.
Stop making her yell, Leslie.
Don't have her have a stroke. Can't you hear
it? Can I?
A heart attack.
I never said you know.
Yeah, they're. I think they're about 800 away from homelessness here. This is right before they moved in with Grandpa.
Anger, Grandpa.
On top like Jennifer Richards.
Shouldn't have saved them. Maybe they could have got hooked up with the TGR Boost Mobile plan if Grandpa hadn't saved them.
Hey, it's Mint Mobile now.
Oh, we going we going over to Ryan's brand?
Oh no, we might be switching to Helium. That's like $20 a month.
Oh shit, wow, the TGR Helium plans. Nice.
A real gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand.
It's 11:35.
Same color as Shanny Muff Billy got that for free.
Yeah. Thanks, buddy. Thank you for giving us that money, you fucking weirdo.
That's awful. Is like,
have you still not eaten Five Guys since then, Jello?
No. Not four or three or two. I'm kind of glad. Like, the really good thing about Five Guys that it's really hard to beat is that, like, you really can have it your way. They got a lot of top, but the burgers are okay, but way overpriced. Like, it's just not
worth
it.
That's fair.
Yeah, I think like Shake Shack is.
The fries are really
Shake Shack and In-N-Out, I would say. Like, fuck it.
Don't have those like, here.
No, we don't.
Oh, that sucks.
We finally got a couple of Sonics.
Those suck. Yeah,
we've had a Sonic for a while.
Yeah, fuck those.
Sonics suck, man.
It's good for like drinks.
Maybe
the jalapeno poppers.
Yeah, but you're like fucking
jalapeno meat.
I like how fucking Frank Puck picked the most white trash thing you can get from there.
What, jalapeno poppers?
Jalapeno poppers.
How's that white trash?
Well, first off,
just the worst.
First off, Billy's upset because there's like actually a veggie in that. And then secondly,
I like peppers. You fuck.
And Billy doesn't like.
Yeah.
He doesn't like poppers. He likes boppers. We already established this.
No, he likes poppers.
Stop with the poppers.
Hey, a different type of popper. You Kazoom knows what I'm talking about.
I hate you with the boppers thing.
I don't even understand.
Oh, Kazoo, if you didn't believe the picking up used condom story, the person who broke the story is in the call now.
Oh, what, the Steve McRae condom story that came up today?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's just lore now. Did you guys watch the stream where he tried to address it?
Nah. No.
Wait.
All he did, he goes, well, Sam's a sexist. I was like...
True?
Part of that
story... Yeah, it's true. It's true. I don't know if that's a good defense, but it's true.
And then...
Is that video still up?
Okay, like, let's say that's true. Steve, did that prevent you from picking up used condoms with other men's jizz in it?
For rent?
Oh my god.
It hurt truly fucking Ellen.
The
I'm
rent
that
is
tough.
Too high.
If anyone hurts me, I hurt them way worse. Like Joy would. Do you get it now? You know Joy Holy?
Yes,
I can beat the fuck out anybody that hurts me. Amen. Only 800 guests. Cash me $800. Please. No food. No personal
She's
needs.
Starting
for
to
a place
look
to live.
Like Megan Hilt sounds.
Yeah.
She really does.
That's fucked up and true.
No, she looks like... I think I made this reference earlier, but I will make it again. She looks like those people... Like, when you go to a state fair in either the Midwest or the South and you see, like, the fattest white people that look... Their faces look like they're, like, some sort of bird.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's what she looks like. You guys like, know the face type I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's actively in line for a fucking goddamn refried Reese's cup or something.
If they've had like a little bit too many cheese curds and they're a little bit bigger, they start looking a little bit like a pug. Yeah.
Oh, poor Vader.
Which sucks because I love cheese curds.
And pugs.
Yeah.
And pugs.
Yeah,
I mean, pugs. She, like, yeah, I mean, like, look at this face. You don't think this face would fucking destroy a funnel cake?
Man, oh, yeah. You don't look like her. No, you
Dude,
don't.
She would destroy Leslie for a funnel cake.
I know, you get your good boy.
Yeah. All you gotta do is tell her the funnel cake's in Leslie's butthole. He's keystring it.
Cash us that, and I'll do something back to you for it. Right? We need that money now.
Wait, what? You send her a grand, she'll do something to you for it.
She took Shandy.
You hear
drop.
That, Bill?
Yeah, I'm good.
Spread the word, you know? Let everyone know.
Please,
they'll do something to you for a grand.
No food, no personal needs. It's for a place to live. Cash us that, and I'll do something back to you for it. Right? We need that money now. The word was that you mixed me up there.
That's my phone. I'm bored. You have your loser mess.
If I had $800 to $900, I would, but I don't. I'll spread the word, but I just had a baby, so I'm out of work.
Can you use your other
okay,
phone?
Okay, Shiloh, thank you so much, though. If you did have the money, you would, but maybe another time.
Use your microphone.
In the future, when I'm almost homeless again, you'll give then, right?
Oh, my God.
Because dead. Like,
now
they keep
Billy said
me.
The same thing when I told him my birthday was coming up.
The Metro.
You wanted them to keep calling
Get
me?
The Metro, not calling the Metro. Lucy with the batteries on that. I need my phone. I will be bored, please.
I need to X this out. Shut up.
Why is this guy crying like a baby back bitch? Because
he's
phone.
Bored. He just wants
his
phone.
Phone.
He's a bored baby back bitch.
bored.
I know you're bored, but I can't help it.
You have your phone. You got three phones. No, I never owned you.
Hey, Chad just and three? Flip, you're married, and this guy's treating me like shit.
Yeah, you get on cheating on you.
Hey, Chad, you
remember when Steve was attempting to steal, hide $132 from Cheshire, was bruised, and chose to be the only person in the room to have his webcam on?
Oh, yeah.
Good times.
Remember that one time him and Union Rock, and he got shit on by those fucking random kids?
Oh, yeah.
That fucking happened.
Oh, my God.
I'm here at the Red Roof Inn right now.
Chad, can you kill me, please?
Did you say Chad, can you
he
kill me?
Chad to kill him.
Don't worry, Jello, I got you.
That might become a super chat. Oh, fuck.
Chat, can you kill me?
Yeah, that might have been a super chat.
Can you kill me, please?
That's
I don't
so
understand
funny.
Life.
This is great.
You're married, and this guy's treating me like shit.
Yeah, you get on cheating on you.
Hey, Chad, can you come here at the Red Roof Inn right now?
Chad, can you kill me, please?
Chad, what's wrong with this guy?
Okay, that has to be a super chat.
Okay, 5 minutes, 57 seconds. All right.
Like Chris Moore. We need help now. About to be homeless tomorrow.
She don't mix up cats and people on YouTube. I'm cheating on her when I'm not. Get my phone done with it now.
When I get back to work, I got you, but I don't know how long until then. Good luck, but you don't get paid until November 1st and 3rd next month. Okay, Leslie's like Keith. He would never leave.
Why is she talking into the ear part?
I she doesn't know how it works.
Like, you're old enough to remember how, like, house phones used to look.
Yeah.
And, like, it still functions that way.
She doesn't understand communication.
She I don't understand like phones. Yeah.
I believe Heather Brooks, but number one, Leslie, don't do drugs.
Right.
And you don't drink alcohol. Right. You've seen him drink alcohol lately at all, everyone, have you?
Nope.
No alcohol in here. Maybe wine, maybe this month if we can afford it.
Yeah, he's just asking to die, so he's doing well.
What Shyla says. Really important, then.
Your own phone.
I want to eat food probably at 9:30 because I have to do all this stuff, right? What happened to your payments from this month?
Well, hey, Sam, how do you get your hairline?
Hey, I shaved my head now.
Exactly.
That was the most
we need a side-by-side of Sam and him. Who wore it better?
Damn. Jill, I hope you get hit by a bus. I know you
don't understand.
The problem with threatening Jello with getting hit by a bus is that implies that he would actually leave the house.
Yeah, no, I'm good here.
I hope you have a stroke picking up your mom's delivery.
All right, that could happen.
Yeah.
Jill is like, wait a minute.
Jill, what's your policy on if your mom? No.
That would be very sad.
God damn.
In the pocket.
That'd be a very sad day. I'd sound like Leslie without his phone.
Big 75.
Chad, kill me, please. I need my mom.
Can someone severely get me hold of my mom?
I need G-Man right now.
Oh, God.
Help me. And some other money for a place to live, like the motel, because we're basically homeless right now.
No.
Yeah, the Red Roof Inn right now, but I'll talk to you later. I'm busy on YouTube Live.
I love your stuff. No.
Just stop.
Oh,
I love
so
you, Crystal.
Goddamn.
Stop.
She is so damn abusive. It's almost impressive.
Yeah.
They're homeless both bastards, so that's good.
Mm. How come they only had enough
money for the hotel for one night, but they brought in like at least 3 days worth of snacks.
Was they all plan on leaving?
It's probably like EBT or something.
Ouch.
No. Wait, you think that's more than 3 days of snacky snacks? Not
the way
her.
He's eating, yeah.
Red roof and marina, but I'll talk to you later. I'm busy on YouTube live.
I like how they have a Stouffer's on the bed, like you're not supposed to put that in the refrigerator.
He's going to eat it.
I love your Stouffer's.
Just stop.
Oh, I'm really bored. You always take my phone when you got your phone, and I can never watch the video or do anything.
Take her phone. It's plugged in 3 feet from you.
People can't fool me. You're all fake. Courtney, block them all now. We don't have no drugs in here. What the hell? People...
So that's how the cops will call you,
well,
right?
You know, I know when a cop is working.
Yeah.
There's no detective yet.
We got a real cop coming here. We know. So your voice is echoing. Should it be echoing to the phone?
Hello?
Hey, I'm calling for Leslie. We're supposed to...
Okay, who did that? You're the best.
It gets better.
Ow, Crystal, everybody calls and you're getting paranoid for no reason.
It's just like that movie where it never stops, isn't it? Screen call. It's called The Cops, They Don't Stop.
Wait, does he have a phone there?
I don't know.
Does he? Wait, play it back. He yep, just, there it is. He's got a phone.
He does have a phone.
He's got a phone. He's he had it keistered. About her being on her phone. He's got her phone plugged in right there, and she's video, and she's.
I'm gonna do the app.
This fucker it's had that four. Phone in his prison pocket over there.
How the hell are you gonna be complaining to the internets about being fucking homeless and have 8 fucking phones?
Rod pockets.
Yum.
I just don't understand anything that's happening right now. It's all going way over my head.
I'm trying to like do certain things, they won't stop. Everyone, they won't stop. Block them now, Matthew the King. Now, please and thank you, the bad ones that are saying stuff about me and Leslie. What?
15-8 right, man.
The cops, I hope.
Okay.
I'm not trying.
Be quiet.
I'm trying to grow.
Hello. Not fair, something bitch.
Yeah, I watch your vlogs all the time.
You're so hot.
Since Crystal gave out her number on YouTube, or millions of people fucking calling her from different
around the world, please.
Around the world. And I'm not doing anything. All I was saying is,
you're so hot.
Hello?
That was funny.
David.
David who?
Leslie knows who I am. Put him on the phone.
Okay, which David?
I don't know who you are. I just want to talk to Leslie.
You know I'm from where? Detroit, Michigan?
Yeah, I'm from Lansing. Where are you?
I'm Crystal Anna Gallant Jorgensen, his wife, and when I'm 40, like Paris Hilton, she's married to Carter Graham.
Okay, put Leslie on the phone.
All these people keep texting me from my YouTube live, 1,000 million people, since I gave them my number.
Leslie,
you're so hot!
I just want to talk to him.
No, he hasn't gave nobody no number.
Yes, I hear you.
Have you given someone a number? Leslie!
I said, no.
David, have you
given I don't remember giving your number out at all.
And someone's out to hurt me and him too, to let you know.
I'm not going to keep calling you retarded. That was not nice. Yeah.
He's going to rape Leslie.
That's not nice.
Why?
I don't know. He's straight. Like Lance. Straight like my ex Lance.
Who's Lance?
My ex fiance.
Who's Lance?
Leslie.
Do you really want to hate me?
I was with her maybe 13
little.
Years.
You start singing, probably.
Here, love you to talk. I was trying to talk. I can never get to talk to you.
Who's this?
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I swear.
Georgia.
I'm sorry.
Georgia.
All right. Look at that phone back, man.
Hello?
Bert.
Hey, Miss Crystal?
Yeah, who is this?
Hey, my name is Mike Geek. I'm a lawyer. I represent people having trouble with internet trolls.
Pittsburgh.
Your number from, like,
YouTube
video, I guess.
Yeah, I'm just going to do it too. Like, you're walking on my YouTube. That's all I'm doing, and they're starting their shit with me to let you know, sir.
Do you not need help dealing with people harassing you?
Yes, I do. If you're real, not fake.
Well, I do. No, I'm very real. I do pro bono work. Hey, my love.
Very real.
Oh, my God. They're bullying me too. Like I'm cheating on my fiance going downstairs.
Oh, you're being bullied. Yes, see, this is what I did.
See, and look, they're calling. Answer the phone, Crystal.
Which one?
Answer the phone. They're calling the damn phone. They're calling the phone. Hello? Bullying me.
I can't,
it ring, it's unplugged. Oh, yeah, they're
calling my... Okay, that's creepy. Yeah. Look, the phone rang. Look, it's unplugged.
Drippy? It sounds drippy to me.
I see Grampy got in on the action, too.
Screenshot that. Thank you.
My God, it's a ghost. The ghosts are trolling us now.
What
are the ghosts that Grampy's
talking about? You really want to make me cry.
You know what they're calling? Yeah. They're calling over bit. Some guy saying he's going to come on rape me and everything, too.
No, Crystal already did that. We saw it.
Plugged and it's calling when it's unplugged, too.
Hello? Are you still there?
Yeah, I'm here, but did you hear me? Okay, I unplugged the phone, and how is it calling when it's unplugged?
The phone was still ringing
the wrong part. Jesus, fuck!
This thing is just essentially a wire and two fucking speakers. It's
we
nothing.
Really are reviewing.
Do you really want to make me cry?
I kind of now.
Yeah. Did we yet?
I'm just hearing really horrible words.
He's trying to talk to you. The phone was still ringing out being plugged in.
I'm here to help, and you seem like the perfect case, but you seem like you're being quite the tremendous.
I don't believe me, but whatever. Number gonna suck. It's gonna be forever.
Yeah, you gave your number out. See?
Which number? The new one or the old one?
I don't think it's real, Chris. I don't think
the one they're calling you on.
I don't think so.
Don't open the door.
It didn't sound like second ghost at all.
Everyone, just don't call me no more, please. Busy with YouTube Live, no more.
You should never did it. The first
That'll thing
work. About the number and everything, Crystal.
Hey, it's David again.
Can you leave me alone? Cause I'm busy on YouTube Live, sir. Please, bye.
I just
want
to talk to Les.
He don't want to talk to you. He don't know who you are.
You know, David Beckham, dude.
David Beckham.
He knows who
David
I am.
Beckham. Look.
You don't know who you are.
Hello?
This is Shane Wilkins. Put him on the phone now.
Who?
Put Leslie on the phone now. This is Chance Wilkins.
You don't even know Leslie. Who is Chance?
Jeez.
A real gentleman would do that for his fiance.
You're right, but I don't understand, T.
Why this interaction feel like a Cracker Barrel?
Right? I've been to one fairly recently. It feels a little bit like that. And that's even up in Connecticut.
Yeah, this took place in the little shop in front for sure.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That'll randomly have Pokemon Squishmallows.
You're just missing like a kid running around with a balloon tied to them so their kid doesn't, the parents find them.
That's Frank's getting rid of that pesky ass balloon.
He just ties the balloon to a dog.
That's what keeps him looking for hours.
You never did meth in your life, and I never fucking touched that shit long as I live. So you do meth, motherfucker. That's what Keith said. Everybody lands and said you're a drug addict.
Look at us, I'm leaving this unplugged.
You get in trouble for that shit, Crystal. I'm plugging that phone, probably.
No, I will not, because we use our own phones.
Okay, it is 12 o'clock.
So that means you can all fuck off now, in case you were wondering what that means.
Oh, we're ending it?
No.
Huh?
Billy said he had to go to sleep. Oh, I got something for you.
Oh,
wait. Go ahead.
Kill him. Kill him now.
Yo! Yo, holy shit, he dead! Oh, he dead
for sure.
Got him.